Storm Track 12 meteorologist Lester with you here on our Friday, heading into a big weekend. We've got graduations tonight and tomorrow. Of course, we've got Flag Day tomorrow, as well as Father's Day on Sunday. And things are actually going to be improving as we do head on in through the weekend as far as the weather is concerned. Already this morning, we've been watching our time lapse coming out of Oriental. You can see those cumulus clouds kind of bubbling up with those showers and storms kind of working their way already this morning. One basically going from Newport across the river here. And as a result, that's why you see the cloud cover there. And this is the area we're going to look for the initialization of the showers and storms first, as we see the sea breeze front and then later inland for this afternoon. So those scattered showers and storms are going to be around. The potential is there that some of these could be strong to possibly severe. Main threats that we need to alert you to are going to be from the potential of heavy downpours, very similar as to what we saw yesterday. In fact, very similar in fashion as what we saw on Wednesday, as far as the showers and storms with the heavy downpours, the potential for damaging winds, maybe some small hail. Not seeing the shear in the atmosphere, so as a result, not so much worried about the potential for tornadoes for us here from this system here. And then nothing more than maybe a sea breeze shower as we head through the day tomorrow. By Sunday, we are going to be looking at lots of sunshine and low humidity levels for us here in eastern Carolina. Some cooler air already did start to work in early this morning. We saw lows in the 60s across the inland spots to 70s as we headed to the beach. And yes, the dew points are still in the 70s, so it is sultry feeling outside. And as a result, that's going to add the fuel to the fire for these storms as we head on through this afternoon. And I tell you what, these storms are going to be able to condense a lot of that water in the atmosphere here. In fact, look at the rainfall over the last 2 days. Greenville, over an inch and a half of rainfall, about a third of an inch in New Bern, about an inch and a half also, or inch and a quarter rather, excuse me, in Richlands. So there were some spots that have seen the heavy rain, and there are other spots that haven't. And again, we'll get another good shot of that as we go through this afternoon. So any sunshine that we see this morning turns into showers and thunderstorms this afternoon. Temperatures mid to upper 80s, although probably late morning, early afternoon is when we'll have our official daytime highs. And looking at temperatures into the low 80s at the beaches. Overnight tonight, we'll call it partly cloudy. Could be a spotty shower, thunder shower around, but I think the majority of the action will push off the coast by the time we hit midnight or so. Maybe right along the beaches could be a spotty shower tonight as those winds go from a southwesterly to a northwesterly direction. So here's what we're tracking. High pressure sliding across the northern plains, cold front coming through the Ohio Valley. Out ahead of it, we've got this rich tropical steamy air mass in place. Now, we have taken some of the fuel out of the atmosphere, if you will, from the showers and heavy downpours we saw yesterday. So precipitable waters have come down a little bit, but still, it is very muggy and juicy out there. And basically, it's a trough in the atmosphere that's starting to drive this here. Take a look at what FutureTrack is showing us here as far as the jet stream level is concerned. Again, here's our front that we're going to be tracking through the area. And as that continues to come eastbound, we'll get the showers and storms to develop. Now, notice, though, as we head into early next week, the upper-level ridge setting up here across the deep south, and that will eventually, by middle of the week, get a southwesterly flow in here, really start to warm our temperatures back up. So as this short wave goes by across the northern Mid-Atlantic state today, that drives the front on through, drives a cool Canadian high pressure in here for tomorrow, and then the upper-level ridge really starts to rebuild, and that sets up camp across the deep south here as we head into next week, at least the middle part of next week. It is going to get hot and humid for us here in eastern Carolina. FutureTrack kind of times things out here for us. Again, as we go on through the morning hours here, we'll see those showers and storms first along the sea breeze front, and then by mid to late afternoon developing inland, marching towards the coast. No problem at the beaches for the day today. It's late this evening through the overnight hours here. We could see a shower or storm at the beaches. A few clouds to start today with on Saturday. Now, you get south of, say, Keenesville, New Bern, Oriental. That's probably the best chance of seeing an isolated storm developing along the sea breeze front tomorrow. Although, again, I got to tell you, I think those are going to be few and far between. Notice our winds out of the north-northwesterly direction, bringing that drier, cooler air in. And definitely, the further north we go, the better chance we have of seeing complete sunshine for the day tomorrow. Again, kind of see the model picking up on that isolated shower or storm around the neighborhood here between Jacksonville, Richlands, Havelock, Oriental, Bayboro, and then after that, high pressure basically settles right in over us, and as a result, we're going to have lots of sunny skies in here for the day on Sunday, so a perfect Father's Day weekend, but especially the actual Father's Day itself, looking fairly nice. As far as potential rainfall is concerned today, yeah, you can see there are some spots that could get stuck under another 3/4 of an inch to 1.5 inches of rainfall if everything goes the way the model's thinking that it will. So as we go on through today, today is going to be the rainiest, and things improve tomorrow, nothing more than a sea breeze storm. Beautiful weather in here for Father's Day, low humidity, lots of sunshine around, great for any kind of outdoor plans. As we head into Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, that's that upper level ridge setting up, and as a result, hot and humid weather, isolated shower storm developing with the heat of the day along the sea breeze front. For the most part, it is going to be sunny and hot for us as we do head on into next week. Tropics do remain quiet. That's the positive thing. It doesn't look like we are expecting any development there anytime soon. Just want to let you know, our 2014 StormTrack 12 hurricane tracking charts are now out on the streets. Easiest place to pick them up is go to your local Radio Shack. Two locations in Greenville and Jacksonville, New Bern, Havelock, Moorhead City, and Kinston Radio Shacks also have these tracking charts, or you can always download it from our website, WCTI12.com. Of course, that's always an option as well. But while you're there, Radio Shack, go ahead and pick up your batteries, pick up your emergency radios or crank televisions or whatever else you need electronic-wise to replace in your hurricane kit. Have yourself a good Father's Day to all of us fathers out there, and all you grads, congratulations. I'll talk to you on Monday. Have a good weekend. I'm StormTrack 12 meteorologist Les Still.